Hello, passion fruits. Good morning. Let's talk about what is best for your owl and for you. Keeping it in an aviary or keeping it on a perch. There are both advantages and disadvantages of keeping your owl either in an aviary or on a perch. First of all, not all species can be kept on a bow perch. I would not recommend keeping an eagle owl or an eagle on a perch. If you're a falconer and you want to bring your eagle owl or your eagle to a demonstration, for example, then obviously you're gonna put them on a perch during the demonstration. That's no problem. But keeping an eagle or an eagle owl on a perch inside is not really recommended. First of all, eagles and eagle owls make way more noise than a regular barn owl. And second of all, eagles, for example, when they poop, they don't poop straight down, if you know what I mean, like a barn owl, but they, I mean, I'm sorry, but the shit will be literally flying all over the place. There is just no nice way to say it. So that's the first thing you need to know. So for small species, I prefer keeping them on a perch inside your house. Because, first of all, because it's a small species, it's very doable. Second of all, keeping your owl inside will create a stronger bond between you and your owl because you're spending more time with it. And the third advantage of keeping them inside on a perch is that your owl is less likely to become sick. If you keep your owl in an aviary outside, I mean, in the winter it can get very cold and sudden changes in temperature can cause illness in your owl. It can cause respiratory diseases, etc. So that is a disadvantage if you want to keep your owl in an aviary. If you want to keep it in an aviary, then make sure you check up on your owl on a very regular basis. Weigh your owl every day. As soon as it starts to lose weight, you know something is up. And give it enough power food during the winter time and supplement your owl with vitamins. I will make a video on how to supplement your owl with vitamins. It's pretty easy, so that video is coming up. There is also a disadvantage for your owl if you want to keep it on a perch. The disadvantage is that your owl is tied up with long laces, and every time your owl tries to fly off of the perch, it will pull on the legs of the owl, and obviously this is less healthy for your owl's joints. Now, Lucky is in perfect health. She doesn't have any pain in her legs or something, so obviously it would be illegal if it would be really detrimental to the owl's health. But I feel that if you put it in an aviary with just the long laces on, but not tying your owl up in the aviary, then there will be less pressure on the legs. So that is an advantage of keeping your owl in an aviary. Another advantage of keeping your owl inside your house on a perch is that your owl is safe with you. Unfortunately, there are idiots running around who think they need to go and free owls out of falconers' gardens. Every year there are several falconers who have lost all of their birds because people will break into their garden and open all of the aviaries. But what these idiots don't know is that they think they are freeing the owls and the owls can live a happier life, but what these idiots don't know is that falconers' owls are bred, and bred owls can't survive in the wild anymore. So this is really sad. These idiots think they are doing the birds a favor, but they're actually sentencing these birds to death the moment they're freeing them. And if I would keep Lucky in an aviary, this would be a huge concern for me because it happens every year and it is just so, so sad. Oh yeah, one other thing I just wanna clear out. I just told you that you can't keep an eagle or an eagle owl on a perch. What I actually meant was that you can keep them on a perch, but you should keep them outside, not inside your house, because they're way too big, way too noisy. So if you keep them outside, you can still choose between an aviary or a perch outside. So yeah, that was it. That are all the advantages and disadvantages I can think of right now. As you guys probably already know, I almost never script my videos and I make them really spontaneously. I don't think about them too much in advance because I have ADHD and I have trouble focusing and it just drives me crazy. Sometimes it's harder to record them spontaneously because I feel like I'm forgetting things and my videos have less quality than the videos of other YouTubers. But then again, this is my channel, my hobby, and I should just feel good about what I do, and that's why I do the things the way I do them. Okay, I'm gonna wrap this baby up. Say bye to the camera. Bye.